out where we is the best place to put the money, and I thought that was my job. So I didn't mean to offend you or anybody or any department. I'm just saying that none of these things were here before, okay, and they're here now. Maybe that's a good thing, maybe it's not, I don't know. But I'm just saying that you're saying that you need two people to answer the phones or to field calls for you and a person to knock on doors. But we have a call center, we have a media center, we have an IT department. So I don't understand. It seems like there's a lot of resources here for you to accomplish your job. And I'm confused on that, Mayor. I'm sorry.
Through the chair, the one person that works in my department does not work for me. You know, he has a job that is given to him by other tasks that are given to him by multiple departments. His office just happens to be in my office. The two council secretaries, they were previously there. And to me, I want to serve the residents. I want them to get instant gratification or communication when they reach out to the mayor. That's what a lot of people felt before, that they may not have gotten that. That's what I want. I've been preaching since the day I walked in here to every department, customer service, customer service, customer service. And what happens a lot is, and I'll just use Cindy for an example, not that this is the case, but if they go to Cindy's office and they don't get an answer that they want or they're unhappy about something, they come right upstairs. And we want to let them know, they want to be heard. And sometimes we usually tell them the exact same thing they heard before, but they want to come let me know that they're not happy about that. And I'm going to listen to them because I represent them. And I'm going to do every avenue I can. And I think adding a full-time secretary up there is a benefit to the citizens and residents of the city of Taylor. That's my opinion. Because there's always been there. Even when there technically wasn't one, there was another one there. They were just an LOE intern. And I took that position and said, I'm going to make it a full-time union position, which it used to be in the past for every mayor, and it was eliminated during the deficit elimination under Mayor Lamoran. But then, even then, he had other people that would go in there and assist his secretary at that time. Now, as far as the media center and all that stuff, that is something that it's there. I voted no. I voted no on it. But it's there, we're going to utilize it. And that's one of the tough parts that I have to do. There's things that I voted no on that now I have to see through because the majority of the council voted for it. And it's my job to make sure it happens. I voted no on, the Fletcher Park. But we're working on things to enhance that because the majority of the council voted for it. So that's the stuff that I got to kind of put my views away. We voted, I lost, and now I got to move on with what's there.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Mr. Chairman, just a quick thing. Council, speaking of that other position that separated by pay, I've argued it for a while. Maybe we should just at least give it a name so we know what that department is, where that money is being split. Is he assigned to a certain department?
Yes.
Who is he assigned to?
Constituent Relations is his actual title.
Okay.
And it's building and water.
Okay. At least you have an idea when you're talking about it, who you're talking about.
In the budget, Jason, what department did he fall under, do you know? Was it building?
Yes, the constituent relations manager does split between the building department and the water and sewer funds. I don't have the exact percentage, but to build on that, why water and sewer funds? I kind of supervise water billing. It was kind of thrown on me a few years ago. And when customers call water billing calls and they have some issues that they're working on, I pass those projects to this person who goes out and finds out how to resolve the matter. So that's why a portion of his allocation is being to water and sewer, because he helps out with those customers that call in for water stuff. So
that's right. As far as the issue of the media center, we know it dumped tons of money in there. And we also know they had to dump additional tons of money into all that various expensive equipment, which was kind of a nightmare when you start to realize that kind of money that's in there. I'm just wondering, would it ever be feasible to lease that to a company that does that kind of work?
Through the chair, that's kind of the game plan, what we're doing is, we will be the company, but we're looking, when we get the fee schedule, and we can see that there's actual interest, because we already have people reaching out to us. Once we get that, we think we can fund a producer, and then we can rent it out, and we have a professional, trained professional, that knows all the bells and whistles in there, that can, you know, help, and we would include that pay in the rental rate as well.
Okay, I'd like to see it be able to pay for itself, that would.
Absolutely, you know, I think we could actually make money off of it.
Right. You know, one thing that we could do, on the media center, is, I believe around the council, we did this, right, is our study sessions. We would go to different locations, still cover, you know, the agenda, but it would give us a chance to be, you know, physically at, you know, the Sheridan Center before it was torn down, right? It's something that, you know, as a letter, is improving, the council may want to do, so we can have kind of a targeted discussion, and see exactly, you know, what the state is at. Of course, that's at the leisure of the council, and just, that was something that I think both sides, you know, of the administration of the council.
And through the chair, currently, that's, you know, it's there, and we're using it, that's why I invited all you, you know, go out there and let the residents know who you are, and that's a good way of them getting to know who serves them. And it's usually just a Q and A with Carl, and I think it's a good, I've gotten a lot of positive feedback on that, I don't know if you have. Every show, you know, Cindy's was, you know, both, Angie, everybody, you know, that people really seem to enjoy it, because they might know our names, but they don't really know us. And so when you're going over there, check it out, maybe just schedule a call, and you can do a little, meet Councilwoman Brandon, Councilman Sykes, you know, and so it's one of those things that we have, might as well use it while we do.
And just to finish up, for the council people here, and council people, whatever, if things ever got that bad, remember, this council has the authority, not only to create, but to eliminate departments. So that's something that a lot of times has never been brought up, but just so you understand, we do have the authority, not only to eliminate, but to defund departments too. You don't have to agree to amount that's in that department. Reapprove the budget, and that's the way it is, as long as we have the votes.
Mr. Chairman, I just wanted to restate something Mr. Johnson said earlier. I don't think we should underestimate constituent relations. There's a lot of value to somebody seeing a face versus waiting on hold versus sending an email versus doing something on iCare. So if any of you have issues, this gentleman would definitely go out, represent you, hear the issues, report back. A lot of value. People want to be heard, and he may have to be the bearer of bad news. I can't do what you're asking, or the answer is no. But you'd be surprised how often people say, "Hey, I'm disappointed, but I'm glad I was able to talk to you face to face." It works, and I recommend you guys take advantage of it.
Mr. Chair?
Yes.
So, maybe could I get a, like a, you know, like, what is this person doing? You know, like, so they're, are they going to houses? Do they have a list of places they went? I've not even heard of this person. This is, tonight's the first time I heard about it.
No,
so I didn't even know it was out there.
And it's been there for several years.
Right, well, I can't, so I didn't know, you know, I didn't know about it at all. So I'm like, what?
Well, no, I'm sure.
We just sent out 2,000 letters to the most recent Good to Great neighborhood. There was a meeting that he was chairing in this room, getting all the departments synced, and issues relative to CDBG, issues relative to DPW, flooding my sidewalk, issues where we say, "Hey, can you go out and take a look at it?" He's the point person for the city, he's the face of the city. He may not be the one to actually do the work to get the job done, but he's the voice and the face and the communication between our residents and City Hall, and everybody likes it, even if they're not getting the answer they want.
amazing.
You've been missing it for at least 5 years.
5 years he's been here?
The position has existed prior to him being here. A former councilman held the position prior to the current individual.
So is it kind of like a deputy chief of staff kind of thing?
It's what we set up with constituent relations.
Through the chair, I point out one chief of staff.
No, but I just, you know, some of those things, that'd be helpful, right? To get your feedback.
That's a part-time role, isn't it? Yeah, it's a part-time role, so.
It's a salary of 50.
It's $50,000 part-time?
It's not $50,000. Where did that number come from?
I think it's, he works 40 hours, doesn't he? I think it's based on 40 hours.
Somebody told me yesterday that it was 15, I thought.
No, that could be, I mean, if you look at total compensation with benefits, you know.
Through the chair, I mentioned that I don't know the exact amount, but it was between 40 and 50, but I don't know the exact amount.
So it's a part-time with benefits?
Well, part of benefits would be taxes and.
There's no benefit.
Fringe benefits.
Okay, I need to get some more information here.